Christmas in August?
Leslie, it's a 60-year tradition upheld by the employees of Yellowstone National Park. We'll learn more about it later in the show.
I can hardly wait. But first, let's go to Bill Callicott in Los Angeles.
Construction has begun on Western's new terminal facilities here in Los Angeles. We talk with Don Drews to get a management perspective on this $95 million investment in Western's future.
We will have a long-term lease at Los Angeles, which is worth a great deal. It stabilizes our presence and makes sure that Western will have a wonderful facility for the time that we are going to be here. One other thing that is particularly important to us is that we stay competitive in the Los Angeles market, and I mean that in the sense of the physical relationship. The other terminal facilities have been or are about to be improved as well, and if Western is going to retain its significant presence in Los Angeles, it has to have facilities that are comparable or better.
Can you give us a little glimpse into the future and show us what this new terminal is going to look like?
We have a particularly exciting design feature which relates to a kind of a boulevard where the concession spaces will be located, the gift shop and the new shop and so forth will be have a canopy of trees, and they will also have awnings that will come over so that you will have the sense of walking down a street or a shopping center as opposed to being in a terminal. The other thing was that we took the existing satellite, now 25 years old, and it has earthquake shear walls in the way, and we wanted to be able to open that up and walk through the middle. And we have built a tiered terrace area that we will convert into a food and beverage area that will be managed by host Marriott. And they will then create like a sidewalk cafe in the midst of an area in the middle of the building. Certainly one of the biggest challenges that we have, and mostly this is a challenge for our station personnel that have to operate the facility, is keeping the operation going with all of the 75 flights or so that we operate ourselves and the flights that SkyWest operates out of the terminal. Keep all of that activity going during this construction operation. It's going to be disruptive, but I know our employees are going to be able to handle it during that period of time because they have been a part of our planning process. And during the entire designing of this facility, the employees have participated on a weekly basis in getting to the kind of design that will serve them. So they're very much aware of what we're doing and how we're going about it.
Does employee participation in the design phase of a project like this really pay off? We talked to some Los Angeles employees who told us how they felt about it.
We have a construction task force that meets regularly once a week, and we try to envision whatever could happen in the future that will help us to give more service to our passengers and continue to operate as close to normal as possible.
We had an interesting response from the architects when we had our second or third meeting. They said they've designed some other airports, and they did the design on United, and never had they had an input actually from the workforce. And they said that they've come up with some decent ideas as a result of it.
We're capable of handling 30 bags a minute right now. The new system is up to 120 bags a minute. Our existing storage piers are approximately 30 feet. The new ones are 55 feet long. We'll be able to handle one whole flight on one side of a pier at a time instead of going around the piers.
The project is off to a strong start, and in less than 3 years, Western will have a new home here in Los Angeles, bigger and better than ever.
Thanks, Bill. Now, what's this about Christmas in August?
Well, that's what we wanted to know. So we started at Old Faithful Lodge in Yellowstone. We arrived on August 24th and found signs of Christmas everywhere.
Dashing through the snow in a one.
The tradition is carried on throughout the park. Here at Old Faithful, employees of TW Services put the finishing touches on their tree, while hotel guests enjoy the spirit of Christmas and the glow of a warm fire. Even in August, it's easy to get into the holiday mood, especially with a little help from the employees' chorus.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Of course, no visit here is complete without Old Faithful herself. Next stop, a resort just inside the north entrance of Yellowstone. We arrived just in time for one of Santa's unscheduled appearances.
You've been good?
Yeah.
What do you want for Christmas?
A
new bike. Bicycle? Okay, I want a trout fishing rod myself. The best cooks in Yellowstone.
That's us.
That's us.
Have a Merry Christmas, everybody. Bye-bye.
As the nation's oldest airline, Western has had a long association with Yellowstone National Park. In fact, some of the early vacation packages were developed in conjunction with the park, and this association continues today. We're at Mammoth Hot Springs to talk with Steve Tedder, Vice President and General Manager of TW Services, to find out what visitors to this 2.5 million acre park can expect.
There's a couple packages for people that fly into the area. One is on a fly drive where they fly to the airport and then rent a car and come on into Yellowstone and tour other areas. We also provide bus transportation to get people in from the airports, both for summer season and winter season. The buses during the summer can go all the way through the parks, but during the winter they transfer at three different points if they come in from Jackson. To snow coaches up at Flag Ranch or West Yellowstone with snow coaches at West Yellowstone or here to Mammoth and take snow coaches on into the interior of the park. 95% of our business is conducted during the 160-day period from May to September. However, you can get just a richer, rewarding experience in our winter operation. We are basically open year-round.
How many employees do you have working at Yellowstone?
We have 92 full-time employees, but at peak season we exceed 2,000 employees for the operation. Most of our students and employees come from college and universities. We do extensive recruiting in that area. About 65% of our employees are in an age category from 18 to 25. We also recruit heavily into the retired or semi-retired group. About 10% of our employees come to us from that group.
Steve, tell us about the Christmas party here in August.
This tradition came about down at Old Faithful Inn at one time when they had a major snowstorm on August 24th. Guests could not get out of the facility, so in order to make it more entertaining and enjoyable for the guests, the employees came up with the idea of celebrating Christmas on August 25th. So when the guests got up that morning, we had a Christmas celebration on that date. And this tradition is carried throughout the park. So we celebrated down in Utah on the same dates at Bryce Canyon and Zion. Employees exchange gifts, put up trees, dress up like Santa Claus, play carols. It's just an entertaining portion for the guest.
The employees of Yellowstone, the people who meet the visitors with smiles and service, warm greetings, and very good directions. We enjoyed working with them. Right now, Leslie is in Jackson, Wyoming, in the heart of the Teton National Park, to show us an airport facility there that's quite unique.
Thanks, Ken. We're going to talk with Carol Lewis, airport manager here. Carol, what makes this airport unusual?
What makes this airport so unusual is the fact that we exist within the boundaries of Grand Teton National Park. We're far more restricted than an airport typically this size. We have single event noise levels which restrict how loud an aircraft can be when it comes into the airport, as well as the cumulative noise effect, which involves actually restricts frequency. What happens when Western operates their 737-300 is that we can actually enjoy more flights than we can with the 737-200. Our restriction involves an access plan, which actually restricts us to 6.85 flights per day on average quarterly. With the 737-300, we can actually triple that amount of flight.
Tell us about the letters that you write to pilots.
We monitor every flight departure out of here for the commercial carriers and note whether or not they abided by our noise abatement procedure. So Mr. Steve Walker in Los Angeles was able to supply us with those names, and on a quarterly basis we sent thank you letters to all of the Western pilots who were able to abide by our noise abatement procedures.
How long has Western been providing service here?
Western actually was the very first air carrier that served Jackson in 1947. They were here in the summer months during tourist season, and they left in around the early 50s and actually came back in 1980 and have increased their service since. Western has been just a fantastic company to work with. It's been such a pleasure from the corporate level on down to the station agents that work here and professionalism. I've worked with a lot of air carriers, in fact, have am an ex-airline employee myself, and it's been a real pleasure to work with Western, and we feel that they have added a great deal to our community.
A key figure in maintaining our good relationship here is Dave Hayes, customer service manager at Idaho Falls and Jackson. Donnie King spoke to him about Western's operations in a national park.
With the Yellowstone Park and the Teton National Park located right in the immediate vicinity, we serve the north entrance to Yellowstone National Park through Bozeman, the south entrance to Yellowstone National Park and Teton National Park through Jackson, Wyoming, and the west entrance to Yellowstone National Park from Idaho Falls. The operation in Jackson poses several unique problems. The Jackson Hole Airport lies wholly within Teton National Park, and therefore we have to abide by national park regulations, and they're very sensitive about the environment, as we are too. We have special departure procedures that the aircraft have to adhere to. We have to get in the air as quickly as possible. And once we're in the air, departure procedures call for a hard left turn to avoid houses at the end of the runway and also the national park, and to avoid the town of Jackson. Winter operations also are a challenge in operating equipment, ground equipment, and airplanes at temperatures often as cold as 40 below zero.
Generally, what kind of customer flies here?
The type of customer that we service through the Jackson Hole Airport are primarily those, the recreational traveler. And about 85% of our business at Jackson Hole is a recreational traveler, primarily skiers in the winter. In the summertime, those that want to see the sights of the national parks, the backpackers, and go and enjoy the wilderness areas that abound here.
Do the employees like it here?
The employees that we have here are just delighted with working here. They love the out-of-doors and many advantages and opportunities that the area offers. Some of them are local people. The majority of them bid in from other locations, and they're high seniority people. So they came here because they wanted to for what the area offers.
It's easy to see why Western employees enjoy living and working here.
I don't think anyone would dispute the fact that words fail to describe the awesome beauty of Yellowstone and Teton.
So we thought we'd let our cameraman, Dave Ellis, and our editor, Ted Levy, take you on a brief tour of some spectacular scenery.
Until next time, I'm Ken McConnell.
And I'm Leslie Kumamoto.
And we're Western.